दबे क्लिकना बट गया।
Everybody, and welcome to the ABCD show. We are so happy to see all of you here, and we are even more happy to introduce, our guest for today's show, Mernosh Randeria. So Mernosh, thank you so much for being here. And you're going to be, you know, talking about a topic which everybody wants to hear. You can see our whole ABCD show is full right now wanting to hear you. For all of you who don't know who Mernosh is, let me tell you a few things about him. Actually, there are lots of things to say about him, but I'm going to say only a few. So, Mernosh is India's first and only W3 coach. So, W3 stands for Wealth, Wisdom, Wellness Coach. That's something what everyone wants, Mernosh. Wealth, wisdom, and wellness. It can't be better than that. He's also a certified NLP trainer with a focus on accelerated learning techniques. He's a chartered accountant with a master's in financial management. And he's All India 13th rank holder in the Indian Adult Memory Championship 2014. He's also arbiter for the World Memory Championships. And he's a gold medalist, master trainer of the musical windows memorization technique. So I think we've got a lot of questions here for you already about memorization, mind mapping, and all the useful things for teachers.
Welcome, Mernosh, from me too, to the ABCD show.
Thank you. Are we ready to start?
Yes.
Thank you. We are over to you.
Thank you, Amrita, and thank you, Bela, for bringing me here to the ABCD show. And it's my privilege to be here among all of you. Well, I want to start off by asking you a question: that how many of y'all actually?
Mernosh, can you be a little louder, please?
Okay, sure.
Speak a little louder.
Yeah. So I want to start by asking you all a question: that how many of y'all actually use mind maps in your teaching? Type in yes. Wonderful. Good to know that. And how many of y'all use mind map not only in teaching but even on other things in your life, in whatever you do? Good, I'm happy to see the responses. So most of you already are using mind maps, not only for teaching, also for other things. And that's exactly the thing. Although we are going to present mind maps with the intention of you teaching better, but most of you are already using it in teaching. So I would like to also tell you how you to use it in other uses. Great. Yes, planning daily routine, other activities, wonderful. So let's see what is exactly this mind mapping is. Mind maps are aptly known as the Swiss Army knife for your brain. And by that, what we mean is that just as the army knife, a Swiss Army knife, has several things that come out and, you know, it branches out and then you can apply it for whatever purpose you need. The mind map looks like a Swiss Army knife branching out in all directions. And at the same time, a mind map, the tool of mind mapping, can be used for various purposes, just as a Swiss Army knife has various purposes. So that's a metaphor to understand how powerful mind map is. And I want, before getting into the actual mind mapping, I want to do a quick demo of one thing. The quick demo to show that how we currently think, how most people currently think. And for this, let's do an activity. And I want each of you to participate in this. Okay, is that fair?
Yes.
Great. So I'm going to give you a word. And from that word, whatever word comes to your mind, I want you to write. I want you to write as many words that come to your mind from this particular word. So, for example, if I tell you the word play, that is not the word, I'm just doing a demo. What words would come to your mind? Can you quickly type it in? Type in a few words over here. Yeah, toys, kids, outdoor, children, cricket, therapeutic, games. There you go. Okay, all these kind of words. So I'm going to tell you another word now. Not play. And this time don't write in the chat box. Write it on your at your place on your paper. The word is studies. So write it one below the other, the way we usually make a bullet list, a bullet point list, you know. The way we often make notes, which is called like a linear thinking. Okay, write it on paper, not here. Write it one below the other on paper, not here. Okay, please don't type in the chat box. Type it on, write it on your paper. Okay, are we done? Now I'm going to do this same activity in a different way now, where I will give you a word and I want you to write as many words that come to your mind from that word. And let me show you how it has to be done. It's not to be done one below the other this time. This time I want you to take a piece of paper and hold it in landscape form, keep it on table in landscape form. We know what landscape is, horizontal. And in the center of the table, in the center of the paper, draw a circle. If this is your full paper, draw a small circle the size of a 2 rupee coin. Okay? And again, I will tell you a word. First, I will do a demo. Let's do the demo with the same word, play. So the word which I tell you, you will draw that word in the box, in the circle. You will draw it. Now I know some of you are already tense. Oh, I'm not good at drawing. Don't tell me to draw anything, please. Listen, you have to draw it the way it makes sense to you. It's not to be shown to anyone. Utna to good we are all, right? Aren't we? that we can draw some minor sketch. It doesn't matter what it may mean to someone else. So for example, if the word was play, what could you draw? Let's say bat and ball, right? So here, bat and ball. Doesn't even look like a proper bat and ball, but theek hai, aapko samajh mein aa gaya kafi. Or a smiley, whatever. Now, you can, don't take more than 2 seconds to draw. This is not a drawing workshop. So just in the center of the circle, in 2 seconds, whatever comes to your mind, just scribble it, doodle it. Now, from the word play, whatever words come to your mind, just create some branches on this circle, like this. For example, it is fun, cricket, exercise, friends, drama, ground, kids. It could be more. Jitna aata hai, just keep putting on. Some words may be connected. You may want to put another words on separate on sub branches. For example, if you're not getting that way, think of it that play hai, cricket hai. Now play and cricket. What word comes to my mind? Maybe Sachin? Maybe IPL? Yeah? So as many words come to your mind from that, just keep drawing. Then let's say play, cricket and Sachin. What words come to my mind? Maybe, okay, 100, century, or maybe God. Yeah, Sachin is the God of cricket. So let's put that. Right? So go on and on. In this example, I'm showing you only two branches within each, but there could be multiple. There could be 10 things that come to your mind from play and cricket. Have 10 sub branches after cricket. That's fine. In each one, you may ask, okay, now play, cricket and IPL. What comes to your mind? Maybe Dubai. Okay. Play, cricket, IPL. What else comes to your mind?
Wicket.
Wicket. So like that, keep going on and on. Yeah. Then let's say something else comes to you. You don't need to go in this order now. Zaruri nahi ki aapke cricket ke baad fun hai, so now you have to think play and fun. Whatever comes to your mind. Play and drama. Okay, actor, script. Just keep putting whatever the way it comes to your mind. Most often, the words will just come. The words will just come. You don't have to wait that now. No, now let me finish cricket and focus only on cricket and then I'll move to drama or anything else. The word will just come. That is the beauty of this, the power of this mind mapping tool. Any word that comes, just ask yourself, okay, where will it go? Put it on a branch. If you don't find any existing connection to that, create a new branch, but put it. Like this now, fun, maybe carom, maybe video. Maybe video, you may think of PUBG. With PUBG, you may think of a ban. With ban, you may think of TikTok. With TikTok, you may think of Chinese apps. Jaane do. There is, let your thoughts flow. There is nothing to limit you from flowing your thoughts over here. Friends, football, rain, watch, and much more can come up. Okay, friends ke saath, masti mazak, parties, anything can come. Ground, hockey, football. It's okay if a word like that is repeated also. Earlier you put football in the context of friends. Now you're putting football in the context of ground. Do not stop yourself from putting whatever words come to your mind. No judgment, no analysis, no evaluation. Just keep going on and on. Okay? A few rules. I will give you around 4 to 5 minutes for this. And till I say stop, you will not stop. Okay? You will keep going on. But the fact that you are stopping, will it happen that you will run out of thoughts? The only point that you will stop, you will think, nahi, abhi kuch thoughts nahi aa rahe. That is not going to happen. Thoughts are still coming, but what would start happening is that you may start judging your thoughts. You may say, no, but this does not fit in yaar, choro isko. Now nothing more is coming. Whatever thoughts come to your mind, just put it down. For example, you're talking about play and a word comes to your mind, chair. Now you may say chair and take a question, nothing to do. I'm not going to put
music
it.
In chairs.
Yeah, but first put chair aya na, put the word chair. And then ask yourself, play and chair is what? What else can come? And then your mind will say musical. The beauty is that your brain has already seen the connection before you could see it at a conscious or a logical level. Another principle we are using over here is that when you are generating ideas, do not evaluate ideas. Evaluation of ideas is a separate step. Keep that for later. Right now, I'm asking you to only come up with more ideas. Okay? So no stopping your hand till I say stop. Another thing, don't pay attention to beauty, to aesthetics, to symmetry. It is perfectly fine if one of the branches or few of the branches go into more depth. You know, second level branches are there, third level branches are there, fourth level, fifth level, sixth level, seventh level, probably it's going all the way. But then there are some branches jo ek do pe hi ruk gaya. Chalega. Perfectly fine. This is not about beauty and symmetry. And as thoughts keep coming, keep flowing. Are we good for this?
Yes.
Good. One last point of caution. Don't do something like this. You see the difference between this and this? The words that you write have to be written on the branch, not after the branch. The branches have to be connected, interlinked. The new sub branches will start from there. And if a word comes to your mind and you have written it, don't cancel it. Keep it there. Another word has come up, put that on a different branch. Keep writing, keep continuing. Okay, that is the only rule now. So we are ready to start. Draw the word in the center of the circle. The word is happiness. Okay, let's stop. I think some of you still want to go on and on, isn't it?
Yes, it's hardly complete.
Right. The process itself is so immersive that you can keep going on and on. Amazing. So how did you feel about this way of thinking compared to the earlier way in which you thought about the previous word, where you wrote one below the other, compared to this way of mind mapping?
I felt the flow was really coming.
Yes.
I think I got a lot more words.
Yeah.
Very few words at that time, and now I think the words just kept coming.
Right. Wonderful. Yeah, even people are saying, yeah, we could write a lot, couldn't stop. Great. It's going on and on. It's endless. Actually, it's endless. There is no limit. Unfortunately, the way we have been conditioned to put our thoughts on paper is writing things one below the other. This is known as a linear thinking. We keep writing linearly, and that too, we keep using the same old colors, blue and black. For the brain, it becomes boring. For the brain, a single color is monotone, and monotone is monochrome, monotonous. Monotonous is boring. What you just did was you used the principles of a tool of thinking called radiant thinking, which is nothing but applying the way we are, the way everything is in nature. In nature, everything is radiant. There is nothing linear. There are no straight lines in nature. Even the brain, if you look at what has come out on your paper, see how well it resembles your own brain, the internals of the brain, the biology of the brain, the nucleus and the dendrites and flowing in all directions, right? So everything in nature is like that. Even trees are there, even leaves are there, that way. Radiant thinking is powerful because it allows you to think 360 degrees. One of the limitations of linear thinking is that when you're writing one below the other, for example, in that example of play, you were writing about cricket and you wrote a few words on cricket and then you lose the chain of thoughts. Once you move to another one, once you move to, let's say, drama, cricket gaya over, till you go back and revisit it. It doesn't encourage you to go back to what you have already done. In mind mapping, whatever you've put, the chain of thoughts are open. It allows you to keep flowing. Plus, the chain of thoughts coming through the connectedness of the branches, where you ask yourself, okay, this is this, so what? What about this? What about this? And you keep going on and on. How many of you all here, when you did your mind map, you went up to third level, fourth level, fifth level branches, deeper and deeper and deeper? Yeah, some of you all did. Now, here, maybe you didn't have so much of time to do it. But if you do it, if you just keep aside another 10, 15 minutes more to continue this mind map of happiness, you see how much deep you could go. And the real substance from the subconscious mind comes out at the level of the third, fourth, fifth level. Great. Till then, it is more like a template. Okay, fine, happiness, kahan kahan se aata hai? These things are there, fine, that is more obvious things. But then when you go deeper, it comes out from the real depths of your own soul and your mind. So tell me one thing, if I were to ask you to write a book on happiness, a book on what makes you happy, looking at your mind map, using your mind map, can you now write a book on it? Even a 50-page book is fine.
I think it'll definitely help.
Definitely.
Yes.
Yes. And that is one of the purpose of one of the applications of mind maps. You have your ideas put on paper. See, to write a book, what do you need? You need ideas. What we did right now, we use mind maps for generating ideas. That is one of the applications of mind map. And then you can put your language and structure and grammar to it and create a book. One more thing which I told you earlier is that when you are generating ideas, do not evaluate. So even if you're doing a brainstorming on certain options, certain project planning, what all can be done, we want to start some new project or startup or whatever, when you are putting your ideas and generating them, do not evaluate them. Evaluation would be a separate process. Once you have a lot of ideas, you can always evaluate and get that one good idea. Remember this. What do you need to have one good idea? To have one good idea, you need to have lots of ideas. And to have lots of ideas, you need to suspend your judgment. You have to just keep going on with your ideas and then separately dekhenge kya hua. Some ideas would have been really weird, but that's fine. While coming up with ideas, do not evaluate. So that is the Swiss Army knife that you just created for just one topic. Now imagine as teachers, you can do it for multiple purposes, multiple uses. Mind mapping is a creativity and productivity enhancing technique that can improve the efficiency of organizations and individuals both. And it's a revolutionary system to capture all your thoughts and insights on paper. And this is brought to us by a gentleman called Tony Buzan. In fact, he passed away just 2 years back. And I had the privilege of meeting him earlier. And he believes that, you know, our brain does not think in terms of text and toolbars and menu lists. It thinks organically. And therefore, it needs a system that can reflect that natural organic flow. And that is what mind map is all about. Talking more about the brain, this is a mind map of the two hemispheres of the brain. You see how you can enhance effectiveness of your mind maps by adding color to it, by adding pictures to it, images to it. And this shows, I think most of you are aware with this right brain, left brain dominance, right? Left brain is more logic and right brain is more creativity and emotions. Now, tell me, the linear thinking, would you use which of these? The linear thinking uses left or right?
Left.
Linear? Left. Linear will use left, lines and lists and all. Radiant thinking will use what? Left or right?
Right.
Mind mapping uses what?
Right, I think.
It uses an element of right as well as left. That's why mind mapping is whole brain thinking.
Okay.
Because we are not just creating diagrams and drawings over there. There is a method to the madness. There is an order to the chaos. We are putting it in branches. We are having the hierarchy, main branch, sub branch. So it's utilizing both. So it's a good tool for activating both your minds, both your sides of the brain, and use that for more creative things to come out. This is a simple mind map. Only one diagram is there. Rest are all branches. Just more color is there. It talks about the functions of the brain. Receiving, holding, analyzing, outputting, and controlling. But simply put, I would say brain has two functions, which are thinking and linking. In more nicer grammar, more sophisticated terminologies, we can call them imagination and association. So, the brain loves imagination and association. And what we are using in a mind map is we are utilizing this power of imagination, creating visuals, and association, which is forming connections. So here is a way to use mind maps in presentations. Like right now I'm presenting with the use of mind maps. Planning, meetings, creativity, development, note-taking, management, and recall. All these are there, which are, how many of these functions do you use in teaching?
I think all.
Exactly, you are planning your study, you are planning your delivery, you are presenting the delivery, planning presentations, all of that, right? You are having meetings, you know where to focus on, you are creatively thinking with children. And children, you need to have that ability to connect with them so that you are able to make them think creatively, come up with more ideas. I think as a teacher, we also learn a lot from children. And mind maps is so brain friendly that children can easily adapt to it. So if you're talking about how to use mind maps for smaller kids, there was a question on that in the Q&A over here. So Same way, you use paper and pen, use more colors, make it colorful. And a mind map becomes even more effective when you use more diagrams, more drawings to it than text. A smaller child may not even be aware of the big, big words, but you can convert them into drawings and put that on the branches. Teach using mind maps. Present using mind maps. Even plan your delivery of teaching, plan your content, plan your course curriculum using mind maps. Even if the course curriculum is already set and you have books from where you have to teach, you can always convert those material into mind map. So I'll show you some simpler examples, or rather day-to-day examples of using mind map, and then I'll take you through educational mind maps as well. To-do lists. I have read that some of you are already creating mind maps using to-do lists. Your daily lists and tasks are on mind maps. This is an example of that. Yeah, so we all do, but linear thinking manner. Yeah, so now change it.
Yes.
Correct? And it's not difficult to change it. This, for example, is a mind map of a person from Tony Buzan's team, Phil Chambers. And this is how he plans his entire month. In one of the books, he has shared this sample of his month of May 2008 and what all he has to do. So it's a great productivity tool. It is not just a to-do list for what has to be done now, but you can integrate it with your larger goals. Okay, what does this month look like? September mein kya kya complete karna hai? What I want to finish? What are the things? Whose help I need? Whose support I need? And see how colorful this is. It can be put up on a dashboard and that can drive you throughout in your actions on a day-to-day basis. You can look at that and you can take your actions. This is a template of using a mind map for planning a project. Even when with kids you're planning a project, okay, who will do what and what will be done over here, or you're planning a project for your school, whatever it is, or you're planning a project for your curriculum or your semester. That's also planning, right? Planning your semester and everything.
True.
Now with the situation today of COVID, how are you going to plan your online classes? What are you going to do? Do it through a mind map. Mind map engages the student and also the person who is preparing the mind map. You just saw how it worked powerfully and magically for you when you were doing your happiness mind map. It can be almost like an immersive tool, quite meditative, so to say, isn't it?
Right.
But if you are using your linear tools, it's just that use of the tools is not encouraging you to come up with ideas. Yeah, you may be driven to come up with ideas. That is what may drive you. But the tools, the linear thinking, the black and blue pen, what is that doing? Is that encouraging you? Is that pushing you further? Or is that becoming a roadblock?
Roadblock.
Exactly. So you may have those templates in which you may want to deliver the final output. Still, how can you use a mind map for thinking? So often people ask me, you know, where to use a mind map? And I say, wherever you use a mind, use it with a mind map.
So sweet.
So this is a example, a real life example of an educational institute which uses this template for any new project. And here is a filled up example of a template of this template, where they were creating a geography book project and they wanted to bombard or brainstorm on, okay, what all has to be done. And they created this way. Now, template being a template, not all branches need to be completed or used. Whatever is relevant for that particular context, you will use that. Remember, I told you, don't focus on symmetry. One of those may just keep going in detail more to multiple levels, and few of them may just remain unfilled. That's perfectly fine, as long as it serves your purpose. There are no ineffective mind maps. There are no wrong mind maps. There are no bad mind maps. You know for what purpose you are using it, and that will determine whether that mind map is good or not. This is an example of mind maps used for taking notes. So again, in teaching, once you teach your children how to create mind maps, just by playing with them, don't give a lecture to them on how to create mind maps. Like how you just created a mind map. I made you create a mind map and told you that there you go, that's your mind map. So involve the child in making mind maps. together. Tell them, you just show them, you don't even have to call them, label them as mind maps. They don't need to know that it is called a mind map. They need to know how it works, isn't it? So draw with them, use colors with them, and draw how branches, show them the connectedness, show them the power of imagination and association. This one was created by a participant in Tony Buzan's workshop. And usually when we attend workshops, when we attend programs, what do? We make linear notes, one below the other. We say, ghar jaake dekh lenge. Just think about it. How many notes are lying in your cupboard, in your books, unopened? You attended program, came back and not seen them. Once you have created a mind map, it attracts you to see it again. Not only that, in a one pager, you see the mind map and you get the complete flow. Like here, even though you have not attended this seminar of Tony Buzan, which is presented over here in this mind map, you can still make sense of what all he would have covered. But if you have attended and you have created your own mind map, that will increase even more chances of your recall. The moment you look at it again, you will again connect with it and you will remember each and everything that happened while you were preparing the mind map, because it involves your kinesthetic memory as well. Another example of planning an event using a mind map. This is again a template. And then you can go on and on and further get into detailing. So this is an interesting kind of way to create mind maps in a fun manner, especially with children. So vacations are coming up. Where are you going to go in this vacation? Just create this kind of mind map. What are you going to do? Where will you stay? So this one is again just a template, but you can expand and you can help them to create their own. And this is one of the ways in which I introduced mind maps to my daughter when she was young. Rather than telling her, see, I've got a good learning tool for you, you better use this so that you can learn better, I didn't introduce mind maps that way. I told her, okay, we are going on a vacation, so now make a mind map of that. We come back from a vacation, make a mind map of where all you visited, what all you felt. And then once the child starts seeing mind maps in a way that's beneficial, that really they enjoy, they really connect, then you can tell them, okay, how about doing mind maps of studies as well? So this is Tony Buzan. If you were to look up on any of his website or maybe on Wikipedia, you'll find huge chunks of text. Even if you're very keen and interested to read about him, that text itself will put you to sleep. But here is a visual representation, a one pager of what Tony Buzan is. He was an author of more than 124 books, published in more than 150 countries across 37 plus languages, also into poetry. He was an educator. Then he was a sportsman of physical sports as well as mental sports. Then he was considered as one of the men with the highest IQ in the world. He was part of the Mensa board as well. Then he was in media in various countries for various continents. He was an advisor to various governments. His achievements was that he brought mind map to the world. His another achievement is that he is a speed reading guru. He brought world memory championships in the world. And he has a mental fitness trust called the Brain Trust Charity. And there is a software for mind mapping also, which even I use, that's called the iMind Map. So that's about Tony Buzan. You have it all in one place over here. How do you find this kind of an introduction?
I think it's excellent.
Very nice.
Yeah, thank you.
And very easy to see and introduce, yes.
Yeah, yeah. So when Amrita was introducing me, some of you may have thinking, kya hai, ye hai, wo hai, I'm still confused. How many of you are still confused that who am I? What is W3 coach and what exactly I do? I can give you my profile. I first shared with her my text profile, okay? And she said, oh, but this is wonderful, but what do I present? If I want to summarize, what do I do? I said, don't worry, I'll be covering that.
Actually, what you sent me was 6 pages long. And yeah. It was so impressive, but I didn't know what to say because there was so much to say.
Yes. So I have a workaround to that also, which I was holding back for the purpose of the session. And here it is. That's me. So I'm India's first W3 coach. W3 is Wealth, Wisdom, Balance. And over 5 years, I've completed so many workshops, and all these data is there on the screen. By education, I am a thorough finance professional, CA, cost accountant, certified financial planner, and all these things. And I have had 18 years of experience in corporates among these four organizations with the designations. And apart from that, I keep learning various things about the mind, neuro-linguistic programming, mind mapping, memory techniques, emotional fitness, physical fitness, all of that. And my
That's
website is www.coach.com.
Hats off to you, really.
Thank you.
But what I like is it's so nicely put, because when I was seeing those four pages and wondering how I would say all this,
yeah,
you just said it in a few minutes with just a visual. And, you know, everyone could just get it.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. So this is one of the other uses of mind map. Create your own bio data, your own CV. Usually when I say that, some people respond, but I don't have so many things to put in my CV. It doesn't matter, these are all certificates. But whatever are your inner qualities, at least that you can put in your CV.
Right?
You may have achieved certain things that you have achieved in your life, the successes that you have had, the challenges that you have overcome, all of that. So here is another example of a mind map. You know, we teach children to write essay and paragraphs on myself. How do they write it? Text, bullet points, paragraphs, essays, linear thinking again. Okay, you may want them to do it for the purpose of the exams or tests in the form of a linear thinking. But let them do the brainstorming this way, through a mind map. Who am I? What is my father doing? What does my mother do? What does my brother do? What do I like doing? What are my responsibilities? What are my dislikes? What do I love? What makes me happy? What are my fears? Isn't this a better way of doing a myself?
Much better.
Very nice.
Right? And this will really connect. In the text, paragraphs and all that, the child is getting lost in putting the grammar together, putting the structure together. Of course, that is needed. But then that grammar and structure is overruling the ideas and expression. Let the expression come out this way, and then it can be shifted to a text version. Again, some people ask me, but I want to create text, I want to create bullet points, and what if I put it in mind map after that? What kind of question is that? You know, you can do it, but then that defeats the purpose of a mind map. I am telling you to use a mind map wherever you are thinking. Use mind map as a thinking tool. Yeah, we do use mind maps to summarize lengths of text also, and that is what I'm going to show you next. But more than that, when you think, whatever you think, even whether you're thinking, what should I do in this Diwali vacation? It's going to be again at home only probably. What are we going to do? Brainstorm ideas with your family, with your team members. What can we do with your friends? Using mind map. Whenever you feel stuck for options, often we feel, nahi aur kuch rasta hi nahi hai, this is the only way out. Think about it. Without evaluating any thoughts, suspend all judgments and put a mind map. Put your thoughts. Some of us do journaling, right? Try doing journaling using a mind map. So if you're doing a what I love about my family, what I would like to change about my family. So these are some of the easy.
Mehrnash?
The audio is not there, Mehrnash.
Vernosh, we cannot hear you.
You cannot hear me. Okay, just a
minute. Now we can. Now we can.
Let me fix a few things. Yeah, okay, good.
But we missed the last slide. I think whatever you said in the last slide, we didn't hear.
Okay. So here.
Yeah.
When you're creating a mind map on your self-analysis or myself, who am I? These are some of the branches you may want to cover. Your likes, dislikes, fears, hopes, desires. What you love about things, what you would like to change about things around you. So this is about the present situation or your journey so far. But you can use your mind maps even for your journey from here on, onwards what? Your goals. Goal setting template. In each area of your life, where you are now, what is your target? By when you want to achieve that target, how you want to achieve that target, you can keep bombarding in all the areas. This is an example of a filled up template. One more thing where you can use it is something similar to goal setting is having your vision for 2025. Where do you see yourself in 2025? In fact, I would encourage you to prepare this mind map today after the session. I say that from experience, the effect of doing that, because when Tony Buzan had come to Mumbai in 2011 and I had attended his workshop, he had asked us to prepare a mind map on where we see ourselves in 2015. And that was my mind map, which I had shown him and he had photographed it as well. And to share with you, most of the things that I put down on paper in 2011 of what I wanted to achieve by 2015, most of the things I achieved by 2015.
Wow.
That is the power of visioning, putting it out from your head on paper.
You should definitely try this today.
Yes. So, these are some of the examples of mind maps. And
do we get ready-made templates anyway? How do we get the templates?
The templates are what you can create. Some templates are there in Tony Buzan's books also. Tony Buzan has books on mind maps. Out of his 124 books, I think around 50 of them would be on mind map only.
Oh, nice.
Manoj, you mentioned some app also, na? What was that app?
iMind.
Software is iMindMap.
iMindMap. What is that?
That's a software created by Tony Buzan on how to make mind maps, on making mind maps using softwares. So automatically the colors are there, the length of the branches are adjusted, the diagrams come up.
Okay.
That's very nice.
These diagrams from Google also on there.
Okay.
So that is
something we can just download?
Yeah. There is a paid version. There is a 7-day free version and then there is a paid upgrade.
Paid version.
Okay. But there are other free mind maps softwares also, like MindJet, XMind, MindNode. If you go on Google and search free mind map softwares, you'll get a couple of them.
All right. Perfect.
Now let's see some few mind maps from the point of view of education. This is a mind map showing various genres in literature. And in each genre, who are the authors, who are the books, or what are the books, all of that are put in one place. And this can keep going on and on. This is a mind map of biochemical processes in plants. Where the central image is a plant. I want you to observe the mind map, even if this is not a topic of your interest. Observe from the point of view of how it's being used, how the color is used and how it's made more colorful. And wherever possible, you use images. In your happiness mind map, I told you, let the center idea be an image. But not just central idea, you can use images throughout. And images are not something, beautiful pictures or something, whatever you can relate to. This is a mind map of English parts of speech, grammar. So whatever content you are teaching, we often just write on the board or on the whiteboard and we teach it, we put one concept one by one. You can create your own mind map and put it. Right, you can put the central idea, parts of speech, and then create your branches. So this is it. So once it starts shaping up, once children start seeing it, the full picture comes up. Otherwise, you have put something, you have rubbed it off, then you put something else, and then even if you've not rubbed it off, even if it's all there, it's all okay. What was first? Because you wrote over here, then you went there, then you went there. But a mind map is a better visual representation. Now, this mind map in grammar is showing the broader picture of various parts of speech. Now, let's say I want to see in depth of irregular verbs. Here is a mind map only on irregular verbs. So to what level of detailing, whatever, what level of summary you want is entirely up to you. Types of snakes. This is just one level. I can have sub branches to explain their properties, like this one. Types of birds and sub branches. This mind map, this particular one, is actually condensing around 75 pages of an encyclopedia. So whatever you want to summarize and to whatever extent you want to go into, there are no messy mind maps as long as they make sense to you. This is about chemistry. And somebody had asked about maths. Here. This one doesn't even use colors, but look at the imagination and association being used over here. See, the range is the difference between the largest and the smallest. See how the text is used for that. See how the bar chart, pie chart, histogram have been shown. Right? Yeah, it uses, you can use in literature, to in EVS, great. So thank you for sharing that. And this is a wonderful mind map, a very beautiful mind map, which integrates a lot of ways in which you can make your mind map effective. It's about the body's major systems, but see the way the branches are used. See the way color is used. See the way simple diagrams are used. Like for the respiratory branch, see that breathing cloud over there. Digestive, see how the branch is in the shape of an intestine. Do not stress out about creating that perfect, beautiful mind map. In fact, when you have fun, when you have that playful spirit, you will be more effective in making your mind. History. Kings of the Middle Ages of England. So much of data we feed into children, and all text and numbers and data and facts. Okay, they have to remember. But this will make it easier for them to remember. It will make it easier for them to even revise. Right? In history, we had chapters on Shivaji and all. Here, in one mind map, you have the entire autobiography of Shivaji. Entire life of Shivaji.
This is superb.
Very nice. I wish I'd used this when I was
young. Yeah, same here. In fact, to share with you, honestly speaking, even I started realizing the power of mind map when I attended Tony Buzan's workshop in 2011. By then, I had already completed my CA, MBA, sab ho chuka tha, and I was wondering, I wish I had used it then.
Oh, yeah.
I had known people, my friends were using mind maps, but I discarded the power of mind maps those days earlier. Because I thought, ye kya bachpana hai? Kya color and pens leke you are creating mind maps? This is a smarter way to do, yeah? Act like adults. Why are you behaving like a child? All this kind of self-talk was there, especially when I was in those nice, fancy corporate titles. But then I realized it's not about showing that you are the serious guy, but this is the reality. This is how the brain works. The brain loves this. After that event of Tony Buzan, whatever I studied, my study never stopped, and even now it has not stopped. So whatever I study, whatever I learn new things, I still do it with the help of a mind. And it's a vast difference in understanding.
I think
and
this is wonderful for curriculum design. I can see learning objectives coming out, and then you can have, you know, activities to meet that. I think beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, ma'am. Babasaheb Ambedkar. There is nothing on which you cannot make a mind map. So if you ask me, where can I use a mind map? I will ask you where you cannot use a mind map. There is nothing where you can't use a mind map. Hanuman ji ka mind map. Or exercise or top 10 exam tips. In fact, if you look at Prime Minister Narendra Modi's recent book, Exam Warriors, even there he talks about using mind maps for exams, for exercising. The steps of a Surya Namaskar presented through a mind map.
Superb, yeah. Very nice.
Okay, so that is use of mind maps. Some few more examples just to show you that you can have mind maps for summarizing books as well. This is a book of Tony Buzan, Headstrong. Another book of Tony Buzan where a lot of templates are available, Mind Maps for Business. And this is a mind map of the book. So all that is in the book is put in the form of a mind map. I'll share with you one more mind map. Okay, this is my mind map. I am a certified GTD trainer, Getting Things Done, The Art of Stress-Free Productivity by David Allen. And this is a mind map of a one-day workshop which I conduct on GTD. Another book, Getting to Yes, and many more such books, mind maps are available on this website called biggerplate.com.
Which one? What is it? Can you repeat again?
Biggerplate.com. Is there on the screen?
I think we should write it in the chat.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah.
Biggerplate.com. So this is a mind map from there. So sometimes, you know, you want to read books, but you don't have time. No problem. Go to biggerplate.com, open the mind map summary of the book, and you'll get the essence.
Oh, very nice.
This is amazing. Really amazing.
Yeah. And this is just to show one case study. Boeing has gone on record to say that mind mapping saved them $11 million because they condensed their entire training manual into a 25-foot long mind map. Yeah. And 100 senior aeronautical engineers used that to learn only in a few weeks what initially took them a few years.
Oh my God.
So these are some examples of mind maps. So that's it from my side. Any questions you feel you can feel free to ask? I would like to just show my last mind map of where you can connect with me.
Sure.
Uska bhi mind map.
So sweet. I like that.
So my website is w3coach.com. You can follow me on Facebook. It's Mehrnosh W3. On Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, everywhere it is Mehrnosh W3. And you can reach out to me on my phone number, and my email address is also given over here. So this is how we can connect. Meanwhile, I'm open for questions.
Yes, I can see some questions. I think a lot of people were very interested in your music. What is musical windows memory system? This is Shruti Chandak.
Yeah.
Asking this, yes.
Yeah. Musical windows memory system is a way in which you can memorize numbers. So if you are a law student and you have to remember section numbers, or if you are working in a finance related role where you have to remember numbers of how the organization did last year and year before last and budget, and you have to remember those numbers. Appear as if those numbers are at the tip of your tongue. You can actually memorize them. You can actually use them using this musical windows system. And the system is not about rote learning. I have participated in memory workshops like Amrita mentioned in the introduction. I got a 13th rank All India. Similarly, there are a lot of digits and numbers which are given. Almost 1,000 digits are given, randomly arranged. And you have to reproduce the digits in the same order. A randomly shuffled pack of cards is given, and then you have to put it back in the same order. So all these require memory techniques. And all these memory techniques which I teach, they are fun. They are based on the principles of imagination and association, using your right brain. It's not about repetitive learning, rote learning at all. So like that, one of the memory systems for learning numbers is musical windows. So I will inform you when I do a program on that, or we can do an introduction session on that also for ABC.
Yes, I think that is very interesting. We already know that numbers are linked with music. And of course, you know, when we have to teach children who cannot learn math, we teach them through music, but this is very interesting. And associating it with memory, I think, Mehrnosh, you have to come back for this.
Sure. It will be my privilege.
Mehrnosh, Kajal is asking that can we use mind mapping for storytelling?
Oh, yes, of course. You can use mind mapping for storytelling. In fact, when I present my introduction today, we didn't have time to present my introduction. I just showed one slide off. But I present my introduction in the form of a story using the mind map. You've already seen the mind map, so I'll just give you a brief idea how sure. I do it. It's animated, so instead of an entirely coming up at one shot, one branch comes up at a time. And although the mind map is organized by education, certification, corporate experience and all, those branches come up as per the chronological order. So for example, I say first I did my CA, then I joined PricewaterhouseCoopers. So according to that, the branches come up. So in storytelling also, you can use mind map. You can draw a mind map and explain your characters. They may not go in the same flow. The mind map can be, you can evolve the mind map in different branches. But the branches may open up in the form of a story. Okay, so for example, if you're talking about the story of the hare and the tortoise. I'm just giving a simple random example. So tortoise is there, and what he did, what does the tortoise want to do, what does the hare want to do, both of them, and then both connecting how they met and they went on that journey. So all of that can be explained. It becomes even more fun, actually. Mind map can be used for storytelling, definitely.
How can tables be taught through mind mapping? This is a question from Pushpa Kothari.
Yeah. So tables, it can be taught. So maybe you can have one mind map for the table of two. One mind map for the table of three. One mind map for the table of four. You don't have to put all the tables in a single mind map, right? So you can, there can be a central idea, table of two. And then in each branch, you can have the branch numbered as, let's say, 2, and 2 into 2, outer side is 4. Now that visual representation becomes a very good memory tool, especially when they are revising.
Right.
So yes, it can be taught, and you can use more creativity in that. You can add some more pictures, how 2 and 2 become 4 and all that. You can apply whatever you use in teaching tables, whatever creative techniques you are using in teaching tables, you can use it along with a mind. And see how the efficiency further enhances.
Yes, I can see if you put in those groups, those sets, you know, of 2, 2, 2. So the child can visually see it and associate and then know it is 6. So he already knows it, rote learning. And now he also can see the visual representation for understanding.
Exactly.
Very nice idea, because then conceptually the child is clear.
Yeah. And the dependency on rote learning stops. In fact, just today I was having another session with a college just before this on how to use these memory techniques, how memory techniques can become fun Remembering answers need not be a stressful thing. So there are techniques like journey method, memory palace. You can search on Google, and they are very powerful. They use the power of creativity, imagination, association. In fact, these are the techniques which are used by people in the memory championships.
I think we'll have to call you again, Mehrnosh, for all these things. All yes. People can attend their workshops.
It's always my pleasure.
Very nice.
I hope I haven't missed any of the questions, because I think some of you have written it in the chat box.
Yeah,
it's a little difficult to find it over here. Request you all to please put it in the question and answer section.
I think Mehrnosh has covered most of the questions. And beautifully, I would say, Mehrnosh, I would like to thank you so much. I've learned so much personally today over here. Even though I had done mind mapping long back in my school days, but refreshing this again has really brought it back to me. And I'm surely going to use it I'm going to write a puppetry book very soon. So I'm going to use it for my book writing as well. So thank you, Mehrnosh, today for that. And before we end today's session, I would like to also introduce our next speaker. For next Wednesday, which is 30th October, 4 p.m., is Geeta Dalal. She's going to be talking on performing and visual arts in the preschool curriculum. She is the HOD Learner Support Center, JBCN International School, Borivali. So until next time, see you all again. Hope you enjoyed today's session as much as we did. Thank you, Mehrnosh, again.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. It was lovely.
Bye-bye.
Bye. All the best. Happy learning.
You too. Yes, thank you.